old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Verse 18 says, and all things are of God. What that means is God did all these things. Now notice these next words. Who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and hath given unto us the ministry of reconciliation. Now I know we don't speak King James English anymore, and we don't use the word hath, H-A-T-H. I don't ever say that in my everyday language, but do you know what it means? You understand it means has. Now, I'm not a grammarian, I'm not an English teacher, but just think, for, is has or hath, is that present tense, past tense, or future tense? Past tense, isn't it? Hath means something that has happened already. That means all these things, God did all this, that we just read about. All these things are of God, listen, who hath, past tense, who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and hath given unto us the ministry of, notice, not retribution, but reconciliation. Not the ministry of judgment, but the ministry of reconciliation. Speaking of 9/11, by the way, I've read a lot about that. You know, there were some miraculous things that happened. God was at work for getting people out of that. God was at work. I read one story about a woman who, I think it was a woman who was working on the one of the floors adjacent to where the plane hit. And then, of course, everything just, you know, fell down in smoke and there's fire, and she's pinned under a desk, and people, she's trapped in the smoke and she's choking, and she finally realized, I'm not going to be able to get out of here.
lives within us if we trust him. That's why Paul says, Christ in you, the hope of glory. He only wants one thing out of us. There's just one thing he wants out of us or the world or anybody. That's trust in him. Rely upon him. Let him work. Because he's the only one that's got the power to do it. And Paul wrote to Philippians, writing to Christians, and he said, he that began a good work in you will bring to completion. He didn't say he began it like you see if he finished it. He said, he that began it will bring to completion. But where does that leave us? What are we supposed to do? What's this written in the Bible for? Why is this information in the Bible? It's there for you to take it and embrace it and believe it. We're supposed to believe it. Now, you know what? If you really believe it, you really believe that God is.
Did I finish the whole? Yeah. Not counting up or holding against men. Let's just make it personal. Not counting up or holding against me my trespasses. He's already put them on Jesus, and Jesus took them away, and they're now put away. Now, all he wants is not, he's not interested in retribution, he's interested in reconciliation of us being brought close together. You know, if we would have gone on reading chapter 8 of Hebrews through chapter 9, chapter 10, he finally concludes that argument by saying, because of all these things he's done, because of all this is now done, let us draw near to God with a heart cleansed, our hearts cleansed from a guilty conscience. Draw near to God. That's all he wants for us to do, is to believe in him and to draw near to him. Now, I've got some more things I could read to you, but I think I've made the point well enough. Let's all stand up today.